Hello, I'm Chris Jordan, Chief Nursing Officer for St. Peter's Health Partners Acute Division, and I want to take a minute to wish everybody a very happy Nurses Month. When the American Nurses Association named 2020 the Year of the Nurse, they had no idea how true this would be. Coronavirus will undoubtedly change the face of healthcare and the healthcare delivery system as we know it. We as nurses entered this field out of a deep desire to help those less fortunate, to serve the health of our communities. Never in our wildest dreams did we picture this. Coronavirus has challenged our resilience and our resolve. It's challenged our humanity. Simple hand gestures, such as handshakes, have been replaced by courtesy waves. The hug of a child when we return from work has been replaced by a quick shower and change of clothes before we even think about touching them. Interactions with the general public have been replaced by mistrust, masking, and social distancing. In the face of a virus shrouded in uncertainty and misinformation, we have been subjected to heightened anxiety and stresses. Nationally, shortages of PPE create fear that you won't have what you need to keep yourself and your family safe when you're at work. Changes in our practice model have shaken our nursing colleagues out of their comfort zones and forced us into situations that are truthfully anxiety provoking. In one of the worst economies in recent memory, significant reductions in volume, whether it be office visits, surgical cases, or emergency department visits, make us question whether we'll still have a job tomorrow. Through all of this, I've seen our nursing colleagues come together like never before. The resilience of those working at the front line has been completely unexpected. While there's still concern, I see joy in the face of our colleagues. While the unknown still exists, we approach it with an attitude of, I got this. Having served as the chief nursing officer for just over a year, I could not be more impressed at the level of professionalism, compassion, and caring of all of our nursing colleagues across St. Peter's Health Partners. While COVID-19 will certainly be with us for some time, I look forward to us re-emerging from this pandemic a stronger and more engaged nursing body. The next several weeks, we will celebrate this professionalism, the caring, the compassion, and the sacrifices of our nursing colleagues across St. Peter's Health Partners. Aligning with the ANA's themes for Nurses Week, this first week will focus on self-care. At both Samaritan and St. Peter's, we have created relaxation and meditation rooms. Take a look at the calendar for events and where that information will be. Our colleagues in spiritual care will be conducting the traditional blessing of the hand ceremony. And on Wednesday, May 6th at 8 p.m., we'll come together as one St. Peter's Health Partners, masked and socially distanced, of course, in a candle lighting ceremony in recognition of the sacrifice and dedication of our nurses. The second week of Nurses Month will focus on recognition of our colleagues and all colleagues as we also celebrate Hospital Week. Recognition of excellence in your fellow colleagues and recognition of the hard work and sacrifice of all colleagues across St. Peter's Health Partners is the reason for this week's celebration. Week three, we'll pivot and start talking about professional development. Again, more information will come as we begin to prepare for that week. And then lastly, we're going to focus on community engagement. This is a great opportunity for us to look outward and recognize those who have been so incredibly supportive and generous of the colleagues and nurses across St. Peter's Health Partners. We're going to recognize the many businesses in the area for their generosity. Also, we'll take some time to recognize our colleagues within St. Peter's Health Partners, such as supply chain, that have worked tirelessly to obtain the necessary PPE in light of national shortages to protect all frontline colleagues. We'll conclude our celebration with the announcement of our Nurse of the Year. In closing, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for your dedication and thank you for your service. It's a pleasure serving you all.